Commission than SAIT in Italia. We are here for the launch of Spread the Sign in Italy. We are very proud of this moment. Spread the Sign is an international project with the coordination of Sweden. Thomas Lidl Olsen is going to present the project to everybody in a few moments. I will just say that we are very proud to host this in Ca' Foscari University of Italy. Ca' Foscari University is committed in deaf studies and in the study and the teaching of Italian Sign Language for about 15 years now. And we are really proud to have been involved in this project by Thomas, who we thank again, once again. I would like to thank you all to be in Venice with us for this moment and 3 days of work about the project. As you are seeing, there is a very complicated system of interpreting. There are interpreters from different sign languages, and you see how all this is lively, interesting, and complex. Benvenuti a tutti. Siamo qua per lanciare il progetto Spread the Sign in Italia. È un progetto internazionale a cui partecipa Ca' Foscari come rappresentante italiano. Il progetto è diretto da Thomas Lidl Olsen, qui vicino a me, che vi dirà immediatamente cos'è il progetto e cosa stanno facendo più di 15 paesi europei, 15 European countries. Chiedo se è necessario tradurre quello che lui dirà in inglese. C'è qualcuno che preferisce poi avere una traduzione italiana? O continuiamo con l'inglese? Possiamo continuare con l'inglese, benissimo. So you speak English and everybody will.
I say my Italian, yeah, thank you. Well, thank you for being here. It's very nice to be a part of this big launch of the Italian Sign Language on spreadsign.com. We've been working for some years now, and it's good to have an extension of partners in this big Leonardo project. It's funded from European Commission. So that's why we can be 15 countries in this project. I've also managed to include countries outside European Union like Iceland, Turkey and Russia. So they are also here today. And you see, also we have so many sign language interpreters here, why there is a need for an international sign language dictionary which collects all the different national sign languages in the world. It really didn't exist in this big way as it does now. Simple to use in the computers and also in the mobile devices as an application which we call just the Spread Signs, the mobile app. So you can have it anywhere, in your pocket, or in education, or for practicing. I'm going to introduce the founder of the European Sign Language Center, Dennis Lennarsson, to the left of me. It's an NGO we started in Sweden to preserve and run this Spread the Sign project because it's growing so big now. So we have to take care of it in a good way so it doesn't get lost. Dennis.
Thank you. On behalf of European Sign Language Center, I'm very glad to be here, and today we can actually say that we have reached a sum of 200,000 videos recorded, downloaded, and updated, and uploaded to Spread the Sign. So with the latest 10,000 signs from Italy, we managed to reach actually now 200,000 signs, which is amazing. This makes us number one on a Google search. So if you search for sign language, we will be at the very highest up, just after Wikipedia. So this is great. And this also shows that it is a need for accessible sign language. And with the devices today, the mobile devices, it's very easy to get access to video content. This wasn't possible 10 years ago because computers were slow and broadband wasn't invented. So we stand today in a revolution when it comes to accessible sign language, and we are happy that our partner here in Ca' Foscari, Venezia University, which is has highly skilled linguistic and sign language skilled staff here. That's great.
And it's lovely to see all the pupils here today too. It's very nice that you have such a large education here in sign language. It's lovely to see.
Thank you. I'm going to introduce you Pier Alessandro Samueli, consigliere del direttivo dell'Ente Nazionale Sordi, con sede a Roma, che è qui per portare il saluto dell'ENSA. Well, I think I started in English and then I switched to Italian. I'm sorry, I'll say it again. So I'm introducing Pier Alessandro Samueli, who is the representative of the Italian Association of the Deaf, Ente Nazionale Sordi. He's going to welcome you all on behalf of ENS in Roma. So it will be translated into Italian, and then from Italian into English.
Buongiorno a tutti. Grazie a tutti a nome dell'ENS, grazie alla professoressa Cardinaletti per avermi invitato qui. E il presidente Petrucci vi saluta tutti. Io appunto come rappresentante dell'ENS sono orgogliosa di questa partecipazione di Ca' Foscari, e che ha dimostrato il suo impegno per la ricerca linguistica sulla LIS, e Ca' Foscari si è sempre dimostrata vicino all'ENS con l'obiettivo di formare interpreti, di lavorare appunto per la comunità sorda e quindi inserirsi nel tessuto sociale, nell'ambito lavorativo, nell'ambito della televisione, nell'ambito della vita quotidiana. E questo progetto, questa esperienza, diciamo, si ricollega un po' alla situazione attuale italiana. Sapete che manca il riconoscimento della lingua dei segni italiana. E questo progetto, quindi Spread the Sign, si rivela molto importante perché va direttamente al concreto. Quindi non sono solo parole, ma sono proprio fatti. Si dimostra che esiste una lingua al pari delle altre, e quindi si ricollega poi anche al mondo della ricerca. Il mondo della ricerca deve assolutamente dimostrare il suo massimo supporto in questo senso. Quindi,
I would like to thank you for inviting me here, and I bring the greeting from the president of the Italian Association for the Deaf, And I would like to thank Professor Cardinaletti for inviting me here and Ca' Foscari University. We are very pleased for the work that the university has been doing all these years in the formation of educators for the deaf, both for interpreting services and as a support for the deaf families. And this is very important for Italy, as Italy at the present lacks a recognition of the Italian Sign Language. So this project, Spread the Sign, is actually really important, as it is a concrete act, it is a concrete project that takes Italian Sign Language at the same level of other sign languages, European sign languages.
Io ho la delega per l'area formazione e vedo che proprio in altri paesi negli altri paesi qui ci sono altre lingue, ci dovrebbe essere una sorta di collaborazione per garantire il rispetto della Convenzione ONU. Voi che siete arrivati fin qua e siete presenti oggi ci date il vostro sostegno, quindi la collaborazione deve essere sempre garantita, università, società, devono sempre lavorare di pari passi al fine di garantire maggiore visibilità nel contesto quotidiano. Quindi questo è l'augurio che si pone appunto l'ente Sordi e spera appunto che il lavoro non finisca. Grazie anche all'impegno degli studenti si può costruire un futuro migliore per tutti. Grazie.
My work is associated into education, so it is very important that the education toward sign language and toward operators that are going to work in this field grows, and this is what we wish for the future, that students and the university carry out the important function of realizing what ONU, the European invitation, has certificated and invited European countries to make the sign language in the different country be spread and be part of the communities and being integrated in the hearing community and be spread among the different countries. So thank you.
When it started, the dictionary, it was a focus on the vocational education. So we had many of those fields covered with different words for different vocational subjects. Could be tools, ways of working. But that has grown now, lately, and within a couple of months we will launch a new website, and also in that we will have a brand new category system, which is kind of related to the Dewey system that's in most university libraries around the world. So it's kind of familiar category system. And there we have a lot of new categories which we didn't have before. Before we only had the vocational as categories, but it's kind of core language. You want to know other stuff, like if you go on holiday you want small talk or tourist words, and if you're educating pupils in mathematics you would like to have the mathematics science. So now it's in the new category system, it's much better, and you can go deep down in the special field, a special interest area of yours. Then it's up to the pedagogue to use the dictionary as he or she likes. But also in the Spread Design dictionary we will develop spaces where countries can put the educational material which make use of the dictionary in a much better way. A dictionary itself can be kind of boring, you know, it's a dictionary, it's just words. But if you take all those videos and put into a context picture or do your own educational material that's visual, then it becomes very practical in use, and suddenly you can build up a basic course for sign language user, like parents of deaf children could learn something from, and we could do magic things with the content we have. Since it grows so big, it's better to get use of the big dictionary in a good way than just preserve it as a dictionary.
Other questions?
For example, for the educational area, for other areas, for like nurseries, kindergarten and things like that. But with the project's only going to run until two more years, till 2015, but it will take many more years, won't it?
The partners in this project is just a small amount of the partners we will have in the future. In the future, we will have probably all the world connected to the dictionary, and there will be several projects, and there might be several partners that fund their own videos and content. So let's not focus on this specific network, Leonardo network project we're having now. It will finish in 2015 and we will reach 15,000 videos per country. But we will have countries that will go beyond that, that will move towards 20, 30,000 videos by themselves because they are funded by the government. And yes, we will have a lot of fields like those you mentioned, like kindergarten or whatever. We will, in the new category system, have, let's say, 15 main groups, and under those groups there will be perhaps 20 subgroups, and under those there will be subgroups. So you can have a very, very small field of your special interest, and it can fit in this category system.
And let me say, after these 2 years, we also hope that the university will continue to add values to this dictionary, because it's all built on also connecting the network and take usage of all the skills that is out there. So it's all about Spread Design in some ways, like sign language Wikipedia, where we all can be, or skilled people can be proofreaders, and we can add content to it. So we feel strongly that it will survive even after this project phase within a university or a deaf organization or a volunteer organization, just like ours in the European Sign Language Center.
And there could also be local special interest groups who wants to add a certain amount of words and videos to the dictionary, and it's okay. They can we can put in a variation on your language if you live in the southern part and don't sign as they do in the north of your country. We can have variation of one word. It could be signed perhaps in four ways in one country. All those variations should also fit in the dictionary, so when you enter a word you can see, it signs in three ways in Italian, and there is a small explanation also to each word, which say, Sicily, Rome, and Milan, so you know where it's from, and so it's a good way of enlarging the dictionary. Right now, most of our partners here now just put in the most common words, the most popular, the biggest, perhaps, just one, but there is a possibility to add all the variations you have in your country, and it's good to know that perhaps old people sign differently from young people, or regional differences. It can all fit into the dictionary quite well.
I think this is a key advantage of having a video dictionary, which is much more flexible than a book. And there is work done, for example, on the regional variants of Italian Sign Language. There is still a lot of variation of the language. Is not yet fully standardized. And I think as a university with a lot of students, we can commit ourselves to improve the amount of signs which are present in the dictionary and add signs from areas which are of interest for our students, I think. This is not too difficult to be done. Thank you. Other questions? Domande? Curiosità? We all invite you to go to the Spread the Sign website and see how rich it is already, and keep
download the application to the mobile. It's for free as the website.
To help people, deaf people, with the sign languages. Do you think that these new technologies could help in the future deaf people, or you could add your app in the near future?
Yeah, all this new technique is very interesting and should be applied, of course. We are adding ourselves quite soon the possibility of 360 degree pictures, where you could take a picture in a museum, in a room, and make hotspots on all the objects on the wall, and when you click on the wall you get information in sign language or the word, how it's signed. So it's it's a possible.
And we are also producing a sort of device that could be compared with Google Translate for sign language, where we can track every video to a word. And so this has been a project that's been going on for 1 year now in Sweden, and it's ready to launch this summer. And of course, all the partner countries can also be added into this project in the future. So that means that you can, just like Google Translate, you can copy a text and then press the hand, and you will have signs connected to every word in there. Which is great, especially in developing countries where we have 80% of deaf that are illiterate. This is a way to get important information from the society on the internet with a device like this, even if you can't read.
Give a big hand for this big launch of the Italian Sign Language. Yay.